I said I just want someone real, just someone true. I said I just want someone real, smoke with me, baby. Lay with me, baby. Love me, baby. I just want a simple thing, smoke with me, baby.
That was the Sawmill Parkway between Hawthorne, and we're in Hastings now, going into Yonkers. A good stretch of highway with two traffic lights, but it's a good stretch to for a weekend drive. And it's fall, so the trees are changing. It's pretty cool. And as you get into Yonkers, there's a bit of traffic with the traffic lights and a little congestion, but that was the Sawmill in Westchester, New York. A cool drive. If you're ever in New York, you rent a car or you have a car, it's a good way to drive down from maybe Westchester or Rockland County, one of those upstate counties, into New York City, into Manhattan. It's a nice fall day too. It's clear. It's a little cold. It's like 56 degrees. But it's a nice day for a Sunday drive. That's actually where I live, over there. So I'm just gonna keep going into Manhattan. But this is Yonkers now, North Yonkers. Turn that shit down. This is North Yonkers, so on the Sawmill. And we're by Tuckahoe Road. It's a two-lane business coming down. So if it's congested, it's really hard to pass people. There's a lot of accidents in this because of that, especially if it rains, like especially this bit here, because the Sawmill is, it used to be a riverbed, actually. It used to be the Sawmill River, and it's actually now the Sawmill Parkway. So when it rains, or it used to rain back in the days, this would flood, or the road would be real slick, especially in wintertime. If you have precipitation, it sticks to the road as ice, and you get a lot of accidents over here. And over there, that's Homefield in Yonkers. That's the Homefield neighborhood. Northeast Yonkers. Over there, it's right next to the Hudson River. The road will open up a little bit as we go south. And we'll get a little bit more lanes, but because we're close to Manhattan, close to the Bronx, coming into the city, you know, naturally gonna get congested. And you hear the engine. A car like this loves roads like this where you could open up the throttle and just go. Now, don't speed on this because they are New York State Highway Patrol usually out here, but it's. I always find it's usually hard to speed in New York generally because you rarely ever get a clear road to drive on. And if you do, it's gonna be the middle of the night or middle of the day, and you're the only car on the road, and you know you're gonna get caught speeding. So it's really, really hard to get caught speeding out here. There's always gonna be traffic around you, so keep that in mind. But you know. This Sawmill Parkway, it is patrolled. I'll stop right there to show you if you guys can see the sign going into New York City. We're still in Yonkers. but yeah, this highway is patrolled by the Yonkers PD also patrols a bit of the Sawmill, but they're not as active as they used to be back when I started driving in like 2004, 2005. They were more active on the Sawmill, but you don't see them as much anymore, but you don't want to get caught speeding. The speed limit here is like 55. Between 55 and 65, you're safe. If you have good tires, though, don't speed with bad tires because you will skid out and hit the wall or hit something. And there's also deer as well. You get that up here. So a couple of my neighbors total cars hitting deers driving, especially this time of year. they come out on the side of the road to get, I guess, the last scraps of food from the summer. So be careful with deer. And I'll try to close my sunroof. That's annoying. So we got a new pavement over here. So it's not many potholes like before. But it's a good drive. If you come upstate New York or Westchester, New York, and you just want to get a nice weekend drive, open up the engine. And now we're in the Bronx and the road gets rough. You see the immediate change when you go from Westchester or Yonkers to the Bronx. The road is shitty. It's actually a good road by New York City standards, but you know when you leave Westchester, always, the roads are shittier and there's much more traffic as you get into into the Bronx. This is Riverdale in the Bronx. Now, this is actually one of my favorite stretches of road that leads to the Henry Hudson Bridge, and it's always windy. It's an older community that lives in Riverdale, so anyone that lives here that's going to be on this tend to drive a little slower pace. It's Sunday, so you get people going to church or whatever. This older Jewish community that live in this part of the Bronx, very wealthy area, well maintained as well. But it's two lanes of road leading to the Henry Hudson Bridge, which leads you into Dyckman, Inwood, Manhattan. And but this is you get this road and like open with no traffic in front of you. Some nice curves in it. You can see on my GPS, see how that curves right there? I'm on that curve in the center going. So it's a really nice curve. You got like a like a sports car with good tires, good suspension. Bring it out here. On a day there's no traffic, this is like all Sunday traffic. And sort of people come down to go to Broadway shows in the city, they take this way from Connecticut, from northern parts of maybe New Jersey, upstate New York, so you got an older crowd coming into the city. But one of my favorite stretches of road outside of Westchester, because we're not really in Westchester, you see this car is going really slow and that guy's going around him. They're actually coming from, I think, Maine or something, going to Pennsylvania. And I wish there was not that much traffic. I can't really open up the engine on this bit of road, but it gets really curvy. But and funny enough, there's rarely any accidents in this thing. I don't drive it much because I don't drive into the city, but when you listen to traffic on radio or traffic on the maps, you don't really hear anything about traffic on this business, accidents in this bit of road. But it's pretty windy, twisty road. Got a little brake here. Just gonna punch it. Before I run out of video, I'm gonna try to show you guys the bridge, but going northbound in this Henry Hudson, this is actually where the sawmill ends. You go to the lower level. If we were in the upper level, I could have showed you a little bit of Inwood. It's really beautiful over there. That's by Columbia University, and that's actually New Jersey, the Palisades Cliff. I'm trying to hold my phone straight. The road is really bumpy over here. It's a pedestrian bridge as well. You could, I guess, walk across. And going into the Henry Hudson. I think my video is going to die. But I also can't film here. I could get in trouble if I get caught. So I'll show you guys my GPS. And this bit of road is usually empty because not much traffic coming off of that thing. It's two lanes of traffic and it comes into like three or four lanes here and it merges with traffic coming off the GW Bridge, but it doesn't get heavy yet. But the cops are always out here, especially early in the mornings, giving tickets and pulling people over. Because, like I said, it's empty stretch of road. And if you're the only car on here and you're going above 50 miles an hour, they'll pull you over for like 51 or 52. So, and you, the thing is, you don't even realize you're speeding because it's empty stretch of road and you're coming up from the sawmill where you were going like 60 miles an hour. And now you're in Manhattan. So, and that's the GW Bridge. That's New Jersey. Beautiful day. So I'm going to stop talking because my video is about to end. I actually need a dash cam so I could do a better job of this. Because I'm holding my phone, actually. And this is not safe. I don't recommend this. See what I mean? The cops pulling people over right there. Or maybe an accident, but I have to get over. But see that? Right there. You get pulled over. Highway patrol. Like I said, don't speed. It looks like they're actually towing that guy away. I don't know, maybe he's drunk or something, or his license suspended. What they do is they get your car towed and you go to prison, you go to jail, whatever, wherever you, they send you. So don't speed in the Henry Hudson, you will get caught. If you do it in the middle of the day where there's a lot of traffic, a lot of congestion, you can get away with it because a lot of cars. But if you like now, it's not that many cars, they're always out there and there's lots of spaces to pull you over here. So they don't mess around. Tickets in Manhattan, New York City are not cheap. And it's annoying to go to court and deal with all that. So just don't speed. The older I get, as I drive more and more, I speed less. When I first started driving, I'd speed everywhere. Never got a speeding ticket in Manhattan or New York City, knock on wood. But I don't speed anymore. Most of the times you can't because it's just a lot of traffic anyway. So, but and most New Yorkers that drive every day, they get a stretch of road like this without traffic and they just let loose because they haven't driven outside of traffic on a, you know, daily basis. So you just want to break loose because you get a free stretch of road to do it on. You get a ticket right away. So but I'm gonna end it here. The rest of this drive is just the West Side Highway into Manhattan. I'm gonna probably meet traffic coming off the George Washington Bridge, people coming into the city in the weekend to do stuff. There's a bunch of breast cancer walks today. I think some Halloween stuff going on in the city. There's a wine and food festival in Manhattan. All the Broadway show traffic, everyone's coming in. So I'm just going to hit traffic. I'll probably be crawling soon anyway. And don't want to be holding this above my steering wheel whilst driving in traffic. Because this West Side has a lot of accidents. So that's it. Adios. Oh, give you guys a bit of that. That's 158th Street. It's a couple of piers, but it's beautiful coming out. And New York City is a beautiful city for driving. Not a lot of people show that in movies. Usually when you see a movie or people talk about New York City or show it in pictures, you know, it's like the subway or Times Square. But like, this is New York City. This is Manhattan that you're in. And you don't even know it. Like, you don't see this part of Manhattan. This part of Manhattan was actually celebrated more in the 1980s movies. Like if you watch like Dirty Harry or some of the Charles Bronson's movies, or I think even Escape from Manhattan, if that's the name of the movie, showed a bit of the West Side and drive-in scenes where you saw the beauty of Manhattan outside of Times Square or, you know, Brooklyn. But it's nice over here. Very beautiful for the fall. There are trees in Manhattan. Lots of trees outside of Central Park. And they do change colors in the fall, so you get a bit of that. I kind of didn't even want to say that because Manhattan is getting crowded now. Everyone wants to move to New York. So, but, you know, I love this city. Don't like living here, but I love the city. It's not a place I'd want to live forever, but that's my video. We're going to be crawling in a minute, so that's it. 20 minutes.